Hey guys, this is Zach with Next Tech News, and today we're going to be reviewing and building in the Geek A30 case, because I definitely think the best way to review any kind of case, especially one that you have to assemble yourself, is to build in it, because then I get the actual perspective of what it'd be like to actually use the case. So I hope you guys enjoy. Honestly, first impressions on this case were only just because the instructions didn't specify that well on what part was what. They had pictures at the beginning that kind of described what parts were what, but when you're actually following the instructions and stuff, it was hard to tell what number screw it was talking about and all that kind of stuff. So honestly, some pictures, kind of like Legos have, would have been a little bit easier to follow, but eventually I did figure it out. As you guys can see in the time-lapse below, building this case was a lot easier than working in the Geek A10 or the A20. So A plus on that, Geek. The cable management right here is really easy to take care of in this case because you have a lot more room up here in the front of the case compared to the Geek A10 and A20. Plus, they give you this nice PSU cover with the Geek logo carved into it, and it comes with the case, which is perfect because Flex PSUs are ugly. The Geek A30 honestly surprised me a lot. The dual chamber design makes the case feel a lot bigger than it is. It allows you to have almost a full-size graphics card in it. And the only real negative is that you lose a little bit on the CPU cooler height, but honestly there are plenty of good low-profile coolers, just like the one I'm using in here. The Geek A30 also supports a lot more as far as fans. It supports two 80mm fans as exhaust out the top. And it supports two 2.5-inch drives, just like the previous cases, but it also can support one 3.5-inch drive if you don't want a GPU. The Geek A30 is honestly a gorgeous case. I actually like the boxiness of it a lot better than the curves from the A10 and the A20. Plus, it gives you a lot more airflow than those cases, because as you can see from these clear panels, there's a lot more cutouts for airflow, which was a big complaint I had with the A10 and the A20. Speaking of the A20, let's take a look at the comparisons between the A30 and the A20 size-wise. The A20 is a little bit thinner than the A30, but it is a little bit taller. So the A30 gets a lot more in an actually kind of a smaller package, because yes, it's a little bit thicker, but as you can see, it's also the same width. So it's shorter, same width, but a little bit thicker. The Geek A30 has the same USB configuration as the A20 before it and the A10 before that, but it has a much nicer power button. It's an LED power button with a ring that glows blue around it, but it's a lot nicer of a click than the previous ones, which were just plexiglass that would bend to click this little tiny little button behind the plexiglass. So this is definitely a much better solution, and I'm glad Geek went with this power button instead. You do lose the option of a reset button, but honestly, that's not that big of a deal for me. The Geek A30 supports the same amount of 2.5-inch drives as the A20 and the A10, but it does this by putting them in two different locations. What the Geek A30 supports that the Geek A20 and A10 didn't support is using anything but a nano graphics card. I have a nano graphics card in this build, but this case supports any graphics card under 210mm, which for the most part are going to be mini graphics cards, but there are a couple full-size graphics cards that are going to be less than 210mm as well. The build quality of the Geek A30 was what surprised me honestly the most. The A20 is a nice case, but it's not honestly that durable because it's entirely made out of plexiglass. The A30 has a lot of plexiglass and is pretty much entirely made out of plexiglass, but there are metal rails that actually hold the whole structure together. So the A30 is a little bit more dense feeling and a little heavier than the A20, but it definitely feels more substantial and definitely feels like a much better build quality. It's one of the things that surprised me the most when I assembled the case. Hope you guys enjoyed this review slash build video of the Geek A30 case. I definitely think it's their best case yet, but they still have just a couple more tweaks before they make an even better case. But I can't wait to work with them again. Geek Store has been a lovely partner to work with, and honestly, I'm looking forward to seeing what other kind of cases they come out with, because this is a very intriguing case. Please let me know what you think of it in the comments below. This is Zach with Next Tech News. See ya!